This is a climate solution. Seaweed, found in sushi, cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, and fertilizer, is also a carbon sink. Its ability to grow super fast without taking up land makes it a great way to store carbon and help address climate change. While already popular in Asia, the seaweed farming industry in the US is in its infancy and could boom in the next decade to meet the demand of carbon offsetting. So I wanna know, can seaweed save the climate? To find out, I've come to Stonington Kelp Company off the coast of Connecticut to learn how one woman has launched her seaweed farming business and what the future of seaweed aquaculture could look like. I'm Lucy Biggers, and this is One Small Step. Suzie Flores grows food-grade sugar kelp, which is a type of seaweed, and sells it to local restaurants and shops. Kelp is an important habitat and food source for fish and invertebrate. Her process uses a system with ropes and requires zero inputs like fertilizer. As it grows, the kelp absorbs carbon and nitrogen from the water and turns it into a nutrient-dense food. We're heading out to the farm to see how Suzie grows and then harvests her kelp. So we've been on the boat for about 30 minutes. We're about to get out to the seaweed farm. It's 10 acres. We've seen a lot of seals on our way out here, and it's brisk out here.
So it's such a beautiful day out for us, but not for the seaweed. This is like hundreds of pounds of seaweed that's growing here right now, and this is kind of the beginning of the season. I try to harvest to order because it allows me to use the ocean as my refrigerator. So we just grab it. I had my 7-year-old on the boat yesterday with me, and he was cutting seaweed, and then we just put it in a fish basket or a food grade bucket.
It's so bountiful, and I love the sound of it getting cut.
There's no wrong way to do it.
That was easy.
And then you just want to get it into the bucket. I try to keep it from hitting the boat as much as I can. It's very good.
It's beautiful. Suzie's farm is here in this body of water off the coast of Connecticut. She produces 8,000 to 16,000 pounds of kelp per year. New England is a great place to farm seaweed because it already grows naturally here. It's also native to the Pacific coast. 132 countries around the world have the conditions to start seaweed aquaculture off their coasts, but only 37 countries currently do so.
This is sugar kelp. This is Saccharina latissima. It's the only seaweed you can grow to eat in this state. And that's because they are being really smart about not introducing any sort of species that, you know, could decimate the natural kelp beds or any of the other edible seaweeds or just, you know, non-edible seaweeds in the Fisher's Island Sound. So this is a little guy. Up top is the stipe. I think it's like the most delicious part. And then just the rest is the blade.
You can eat the whole thing.
Yeah, please eat it. Enjoy it. Isn't that awesome? Can you like imagine that like pickled?
It's so good.
Yeah, chopped up like in a relish or something like that.
In a very short travel, farm to table for now.
Yeah, seriously. There's definitely a lot of use for sugar kelp and other kelp as animal feed, as a soil input, because it carries a lot of nitrogen naturally in pharmaceuticals and cosmetics. It can be used to make alginate, which is a thickening agent, which people use in ice cream. So you can see some of the stipes are gonna be longer than other ones.
Wow.
And that's because the current that rips through the site is dragging the seaweed.
And how fast does this grow?
It's a millimeter, first week of December, and now it's average like 100 centimeters
long. A millimeter
long.
The first week of
December. Like the size of a baby fingernail. It's really tiny.
And now we're in April, and this is how many feet long?
I mean,
oh my gosh, some of these are, look at this.
Yeah, and I've been harvesting this too, so I'm cutting them and then they're growing back. That's why they absorb so much more carbon and nitrogen,
right?
Because they're growing so fast.
So how does carbon sequestration work? Well, the structure of the seaweed is built with carbon. So as long as it's intact, the carbon isn't in the atmosphere as CO2. One proposed way of preserving the carbon is by sinking the seaweed into deeper parts of the ocean where it's not able to fully break down, thus sealing the carbon on the ocean floor. One study that looked at the carbon sequestration potential of seaweed farming found that sinking 14 to 25% of current seaweed production could offset the entire aquaculture sector and make it carbon neutral. As more and more major companies pledge to become carbon neutral, the seaweed industry could become a big player in a carbon offsetting market. In the future, someone like Suzie could get paid to sink her seaweed and sequester carbon. Are you doing anything right now to help this sequester even more carbon?
We have two different people that we're partnering with right now, and they're actually studying the best way to make the seaweed grow the fullest, and they're studying the amount of carbon and nitrogen that's being sequestered on my farm, because it's all going to be different, right? Like, depending on what your waterway is, you're going to have different levels. So once we figure that out, then I would like to investigate more in ways that we could, like, I mean, I keep the 10 acres, even though we've only been farming, you know, this 4-acre kind of plot of the 10 acres, because I think that if there's the potential to use the seaweed in another way, why not?
Seaweed farming holds a lot of potential, but the industry in the U.S. is still in its infancy. Remember that map of countries that farm seaweed? The U.S. isn't even counted as a seaweed farming country because the industry is so small and there is no federal policy around seaweed farming. And globally, seaweed farming has room to expand a lot. Currently, seaweed aquaculture accounts for only 0.05% of the area occupied by wild seaweed populations. Researchers estimate that 48 million kilometers squared of the ocean is suitable for seaweed aquaculture. Expanding seaweed farming could also increase food security. By one estimate, creating ocean farms that grow seaweed and shellfish in just 5% of U.S. territorial waters could create protein equivalent to 2.3 trillion hamburgers and sequester carbon of 20 million cars.
And how often are you thinking about climate change in your day-to-day work? Me, and what's really nice is that a lot of the other small farmers, they tend to be oyster fishermen or even lobster fishermen or any type of fisherman. You think about it all the time because that impacts your entire livelihood. The oyster fishermen that I work with, they already understand that by growing their oysters, they're doing a lot to help improve the waterways. And so by adding seaweed onto oyster farms, like, you're filtering the water, you're sucking carbon and nitrogen out of the water, you're helping prevent ocean acidification, you're helping prevent algal blooms, which wind up keeping every other fishery alive.
Would you start sinking some if it was like a carbon market?
I would take 6 more acres, like the remaining 6 acres, and just figure out a way to sink it.
And then get paid for that as carbon sequestration?
If there was a way to do it and it was like a super responsible, like everybody's giving it the thumbs up, I am all about it. The last thing I want to do is like see an area where everybody's just sinking their lines irresponsibly, and, you know, like, everything just has to be kind of thought through. If we're supporting that culture that we have here too, I think that's a win-win, and it's going to support all the local waterfront businesses, because, you know, I would like to see seaweed be as endemic as like the lobster roll to this region. But I'm not trying to sell to Oregon, you know, right. I'm trying to keep it close to home and just see what we can do with it right here for right now, because I really do think it defeats the purpose. Like, I don't put my seaweed in plastic. Again, it sounds very idealist right now, but like, let's just stay slow and see if we can grow it here first, and then once we do that, well, maybe we can figure out, like, I don't know, a seaweed-based plastic that dissolves in the water rather than goes into turtle bellies. It's an industry that just can go any, it can only grow.
So we're back on shore after visiting the farm, and we're gonna do a little experiment and taste test with how the seaweed taste changes with temperature.
Yes.
With what?
Yeah, that's, well, I mean, that's essentially what it is. So I'm hoping that it's
hot. That's boiling water.
It looks pretty hot, right?
Yeah, it looks hot.
Yeah. When you blanch, you're just essentially taking it and dipping it right in.
Whoa.
But so here's kind of the side by side.
So what's the science behind this? Why is this happening?
Well, there's three different pigments contributing to the color of the seaweed when it's in its natural state. And so when you're putting it in the hot water, you're melting away two of the pigments, but one of them, chlorophyll, which is why it remains green, has a higher melting point. But
it's like a superfood, so
it is, yeah.
What does
so
that mean?
It's very high in iron, it's very high in calcium, it's high in iodine, it has antioxidants, it has omega-3s. It has a lot of things in it that people can't find in terrestrial plants. A lot of the same elements that you'll find in fish that they say you gotta eat this, it's really good, it's brain food longevity. You can find that in seaweed, so it's actually a really great solution for people who maybe don't like fish or people who don't eat fish for whatever reason. It's almost overwhelming when I think about all of the benefits. I'm like, it's good for the environment, it's really good for your body, it will make all of your food taste better. Like, it does kind of sound like I'm an insane person.
It's a win, win, win,
yeah.
Win, 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 win.
Exactly. Exactly.
So jobs.
At that point, they all walk away. But they're like, you're making
it's
this
too
up.
It's too good to be true.
Mm-hmm.
It was so fun to go out in the boat today and see kelp farming firsthand. And will seaweed farming save the climate? Well, not on its own, but it offers so many awesome benefits. The fact that this industry is growing so much, it's offering local jobs and creating solutions for our climate, I think it is a win-win-win, and I cannot wait to see what the future of kelp farming holds.
We just wrapped the shoot and Suzie gave us a tip that a local restaurant carries her seaweed. So obviously, we're gonna go get lunch there right now and try all the seaweed delicacies.
And Suzie's kelp was part of this dish. This is kelp wrapped. What is it again?
Scallop.
Don't cut. Kelp wrapped scallops.
This is so good.